pulled out of the tent on day 7 at the Long Beach campground just outside of Tofino, and for once Hammy snoring had actually been a pretty good thing. Remember that murder of crows I had told you about? Well, they wouldn't come anywhere near our campsite, so when we rolled out of the tent, our site had been completely unmolested and our bikes were poop-free.
Of course, Anthony was with us, so we woke up fairly at a regular 8 o'clock or whatever it was, and packed up camp and decided that we needed some breakfast.
So we packed up camp pretty quick and rolled down the highway back to Incinerator Rock for a few more pictures on the beach. So we hung around on the beach for a little bit and then headed south into the Clulit. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Again, another place name that I'm sure we never pronounced the same way twice. Alright, this is our last morning on the west coast here. We're just gearing up and going to head down the road to Uklulit.
Well, Tofino's just north of this town called Uklulit, and I know I'm going to butcher that name a little bit, but...
just outside of Uklulit? Uklit? Whatever. Uklulit.
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 Then we buggered off, went to Uklulit. Uklulit. And had breakfast there. A nice place that I can't remember the name of either. Something to do with a rooster or something.
I finally realized that, you know, this was pretty much the halfway mark. This was the turnaround point. From here on out, we'd just be heading east until we finally got home.
Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. We're gonna do what they say can't be done. We've got a long way to go, and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run. Keep your foot hard on the pedal, son, never mind them brakes. Let it all hang out, cause we gotta run and make.
Now when we had taken this road out to Tofino, we really didn't stop for much, so we barreled through pretty quick. We were determined to stop and smell the roses, as it were, on our way back. Just outside of Uklulit. Just checking out the scenery, taking some pics, hanging out with Tony. He's giving us the biology lesson. Our first stop on the way back was Ellis Creek. Neat little kind of rock formations that have been dug out by this old creek. Now, I was a little bit curious about some of these formations, but I knew better than to ask either one of these other two clowns, because they're both geologists, and we would have been there for hours. So I was content just to snap a few pictures before we saddled up and kept pushing on.
Old Smokey's got his ears on, he's hot on your trail. He ain't gonna rest till you're in jail.
So you got to dodge him, you got to duck him. You gotta keep that diesel trucking. Put that hammer down and give it hell.
First bit of blue sky we've seen in a while as we make our way east. Seems like kind of an ugly word, east. Blue sky, warming up, pushing on. The next stop was Cathedral Grove, kind of a touristy stop. But big, huge cedars at the side of the road here, just massive trees. You really can't help but stop. It's just a really neat place, and the smell of these wild cedars, too, is just incredible.
You can see our smiling way.
Huge trees, really impressive. Pulled in there and then the guys were a little bit behind me, delayed, and came in behind and I videoed them. And we took some pictures and then we continued on.
Jeff's cam on strapped down to Anthony's luggage facing backwards, and then so we goofed around a bit on our way through from Port Alberni over to Qualicum, getting some really fun shots of Jeff and I both in the same frame for a change, because that's not often something we get to do. Usually it's either one of us, because one of us will be shooting the video.
We continued on and hung out at Coombs for a few minutes, and there's some interesting characters there singing, and that's a good time.
Now, my wife had been on the island a few months before me and had actually told me, make sure that if you go through Coombs, you check out the place with the goats on the roof. Now, it kind of sounded interesting, but I had been distracted with something else at the time, and I didn't ask any follow-up questions like, what place in Coombs with the goats on the roof? Fortunately, all we had to do is mention to Tony, hey, have you ever heard about this place with the goats on the roof? And he knew exactly what we were talking about. There's no real way to describe this place other than a tourist trap. There were, in fact, goats on the roof of some of the sod buildings, but it was hot like a bugger, and they were hiding in the shade, so we couldn't really get a good picture.
All right, we are here in Coombs at some sort of crazy market with donkeys on the roof or something.
White and black.
I can't believe it. Jeff's riding a Harley Davidson. Lean into that corner, Jeff.
And we got a nice little taste of some live entertainment on our way out.
So after a couple of days of riding with us, Anthony is about to split off and head back home. So big shout out to Anthony. Thank you very much for joining us.
No problem.
Tony.
So unfortunately, it was also at Coombs that we had to say goodbye to Tony. He needed to head back to Courtney. Great guy. It's really sad to see him go. He's welcome on any bike trip I'm ever on. And in fact, I look forward to riding with him again real soon.
Yeah, it was good. I had a good time. I'd been on a few long rides before, but I always seem to fly solo. As you can see, I'm out on my boat by myself here. I seem to fly solo a lot, so it's nice to go and hang out with the boys, and hope to make it on the trip with you guys again next year. Talk to you later.
Jeff and I had a long day planned that day. We were going to make it all the way into Harrison Hot Springs on the mainland, and that's east of Vancouver. So we not only had a ferry ride, but Vancouver to negotiate, so we were itching to make some kilometers.
So after we bid farewell to Tony, Hemi and I pushed on to the Nanaimo Ferry Port, where we would take the boat back over to Horseshoe Bay.
There's some guys that know how to kill time waiting for a ferry. Cause that's what we're doing. We got about an hour or so before we're gonna get to board up, but we are right at the beginning of the line.